Just like Donald Duck, Goofy's voice preceded his development as a character.
Gosh, a lady.
That voice belonged to studio story man Vance DeBar Pinto Colvig. And once heard, it was never forgotten. Pinto had a bottomless bag of tricks, since he'd spent his youth as a performer and musician traveling with carnivals and circuses. He knew how to make people laugh. Born in Oregon, the youngest of seven children, the natural class clown later said he based many of his characters and comedy ideas on the people he observed while growing up in that rural part of America. He attended agricultural college, but skipped out on classes every spring when the circus came to town. It was the birth of a lifelong love affair. A show business jack of all trades, he taught himself to draw and even performed a chalk talk vaudeville act, traveling all over the country. He landed in Los Angeles in the late 1920s and worked for the legendary silent comedy producer, Max Sennett. But the turning point in his career came in 1930 when he got a job with Walt Disney. A self-professed cornball, he came up with all sorts of gags, often supported by musical ideas.
Well, you got something simple, four characters, three pigs and a wolf.
Yeah, the wolf would make a great heavy.
Well, he's the one that went, open the door, I'll bust it in. If you don't, I'll huff and I'll puff. And I'll blow your house down. Yeah.
And then started doing voices and sound effects for the cartoons. He often panted as Pluto. But he made history with a distinctive laugh in the 1932 Mickey Mouse cartoon, Mickey's Review. This was the birth of Goofy. Colvig's distinctive voice was then heard in the role of the practical pig in Three Little Pigs.
You can play and laugh and fiddle. Don't think you can make me sore. I'll be safe and you'll be sorry when the wolf comes to your door.
A year later, he sang a song that would later become associated with Goofy in The Grasshopper and the Ants. And not so incidentally, Colvig also wrote the lyrics for the song.
Oh, the world owes us a living. Oh, the world owes me a living. Lead-a-light-a-load-a-la-la.
Even after Goofy became an established character, Pinto's versatility held him in good stead at the studio. He voiced two of the seven dwarfs. Grumpy.
I'm warning you. If the queen finds her here, she'll swoop down and wreak her vengeance on us.
And Sleepy.
Maybe the old queen's got Snow White.
After completing his work on Snow White, he and Walt had a falling out, and Colvig headed to Miami to join the Max Fleischer studio, where he worked on Gulliver's Travels and did the voice of Gabby for that feature film and other short subjects to follow. In his absence, the Disney studio reused some of his Goofy tracks. Also found other people to imitate his voice.
I made it!
But no one ever sounded quite like Pinto. In 1941, he returned to Disney and spent the rest of his life being Goofy.
Well, this is nice.
And proud of it. He also gave birth to another memorable character when Capitol Records hired him to create the voice of Bozo the Clown, which he introduced in a series of popular children's records. The Circus Association couldn't have pleased Pinto more. He continued to work as a clown and what he called the world's worst clarinet player for many years, along with two of his sons. Goofy's good-natured personality reflected Colvig's own upbeat philosophy of life. Perhaps that's why he imbued the character with such a wonderful vocal personality. He called himself a corn-fed hick, just like the character that first appeared on screen in the early 1930s, and concluded, years later, I guess I'm still just naturally Goofy. Lucky for us. Thank you.
Thank you.